Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Cert Bros. In this video, we're going to be looking at MAC addresses. So, we're getting closer to the end of our journey through the TCP/IP model. In this video, we're going to be looking at the data link layer. The data link Ethernet standards operate here. Is also responsible for adding another type of address called a MAC address. So, what is a MAC address? Well, first, MAC stands for Media Access Control. It's a unique identifier that is assigned to a network interface card, aka a NIC. And this is what a MAC address looks like. The first thing to note is that unlike an IP address, which can be changed, MAC addresses are described as being physical addresses. Think of them like they're set in stone, burnt into the NIC by the manufacturer. They are unique and cannot be changed. Well, you can spoof a MAC address. The address itself is 48 bits long, or 6 bytes. Bits and bytes are binary values. There are 8 bits in a byte, and to remember the difference, think of eating binary. You take a byte, and you will have a mouthful of bits. Anyway, the address has two sections. The first 24 bits, or 3 bytes, is called the Organizationally Unique Identifier, or OUI. It identifies the vendor. The last 24 bits is a unique value that was assigned by the vendor that makes this address unique. There are 3 types of MAC address. Unicast, which means a particular unique MAC address, like the one we have here. Multicast, which is a MAC address used for an application or protocol. This will be sent to all devices, but only those with that application or protocol will listen to it. And we have something called a broadcast address. Now, this is sent to all devices within a network. And a broadcast address looks like this. It's all Fs. So, back to our unicast MAC address. It's important to note that there is more than one way to show a MAC address, and it changes depending on where you're looking at it. Here are 3 ways to display the same MAC address. The top one is 6 groups of 2 digits separated by colons. This is typically how Linux or Apple will display their MAC addresses. The middle one is again 6 groups of 2 digits, but this time separated by dashes. This is how Microsoft display their MAC addresses. Lastly, the bottom displays the address as 3 groups of 4 digits. This is how Cisco display their MAC addresses. Although you'll likely see the bottom Cisco format when going through the exam, you need to be able to look at all 3 of these and think, that is a MAC address. Okay, so I know what you're probably thinking. We already have IP addresses. So why do we need MAC addresses? Well, let's look at an example. We have 4 computers and a switch. Switches are commonly layer 2 devices. When computers are talking to each other in the local area network, or LAN, this is layer 2 communication. And layer 2 communicates using MAC addresses. But when we leave our network, this is where IP addresses are mainly used. Routers are layer 3 devices, and they mainly focus on IP addresses to get the data to the destination. So in summary, you can think about MAC addresses as local communication and IP addresses as global communication. We'll cover this more when we go into more in-depth switching and routing topics. Before we finish this video, I will show you how to check your own MAC address at home. On Windows, you simply open up a command prompt or PowerShell. Type ipconfig/all to see your interface settings. Find your interface, and remember you might have more than one if you have a wireless interface. And look for something called the physical address. If you're using Linux or Apple, open up a terminal and type in ifconfig. and look for the IFA address. This video is part of our full CCNA course, which can be found in the description. So please feel free to go and check that out. If you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe. The support from you guys really does help the channel grow. Other than that, I hope this helped, and thank you for watching.